A 52-year-old man ambushed, knocked down, and stabbed dozens of times inside his own home by complete strangers.
News 4's Peyton Yeager live in Guthrie, where Peyton, crime scene tape still surrounds that home right now.
That's right, Jolene. The crime scene tape is still up as the home behind me is still under investigation. Now, today was the first full day the victim was able to spend with his family after being released from the hospital. He tells me that that night is still a haze in his mind, and he's confused why he was targeted.
I just can't imagine how anyone could ever do that to another person. I just can't. You're monsters.
Countless stab wounds, broken ribs, broken nose, eyes swollen shut, and severe brain damage. Very real and life-threatening injuries for a Guthrie man.
We don't know who attacked him. We don't know for what reason they attacked him.
However, his family still gripping with the uncertainty.
Someone just said there was police tape around my dad's house, so of course my mind just went to the darkest place. I was like, is my dad dead?
But Cherise Skinner finally got the call from the hospital. Her father, Scott Wright, was clinging to life after three men knocked on the 52-year-old's front door.
It was crazy. It looked like a murder scene.
According to police, the group barged in and began beating and stabbing Wright to the brink of death.
That got me.
The last thing Wright can remember, a final blow to the head that would knock him out cold, leaving him lying lifeless in a pool of blood. Somehow, Wright made it to the hospital. But his truck, along with his wallet and cell phone, still nowhere to be found.
It's kind of like a waking nightmare. You just kind of want it to stop.
His children telling us their dad, who is now almost unrecognizable, is healing, but is still in an immense amount of pain, trying his hardest to move forward and remember any clue he can to help police find the men responsible.
They're on the streets right now.
Again, no arrests have been made, but just in tonight, police did tell me they found Wright's truck abandoned and it has been taken into evidence. Reporting live in Guthrie, Peyton Yeager, Oklahoma's News 4.
Thank you, Peyton. Yeager.